Hello, my friend. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension. And my gift to you today is this video and guided meditation on the deepest curse and spell breaking ever. And so first of all, of course, I will talk about the concepts surrounding curses, which will then be followed by, you know, a guided meditation here at this time. So at this time in our spiritual evolution, you know, we are waking up, becoming more and more aware of subtle realities, you know, like the oppression or molestation of ghosts, you know, or other types of entities or curses, you know, that probably have been there all along, but only now are we becoming aware of them, you know, partially due to the raising of the vibration of the solar system, you know, influx of light, you know, we all heard about this, as well as, you know, due to our expanding horizon of spiritual concepts, you know, spiritual exercises, you know, as well as plant medicine, you know, through the internet and, you know, being able to travel and have access to so many more cultures, you know. And so people are waking up to those subtle things and inquire. And, you know, so with most, you know, of my clients, you know, I deal with, of course, whatever is necessary, but the bulk is, you know, dealing with soul fragments, you know, or ghosts, you know, shadows from past lifetimes or other people's past lifetimes. You know, and then there's, of course, you know, trauma and karma from the past. And then, you know, really one of the big ones is curses. You know, vows are kind of the other side of curses, you know, where we do things ourselves. But, you know, these are the big ones. And so if you just go to the definition by Google on spell, you know, like a magic spell, is a verbal formula believed to have magical forces. You know, he whispered a spell as he moved his hands, or inscribed around his waist is a charm, you know, or spell in Balinese. So these are charms, spell, and, you know, we have to say that, you know, it's like spelling out a word. You know, there is this effect of accumulation, you know, that comes to mind where you create your thought forms and you amplify this thought form, you know, by constantly repeating it, like, you know, this is the spelling, you know, and then you get a bigger thought forms, you know, which will do the work. Now let's go to the definition of curse. Curse, you know, according to Google, and of course there is, you know, this cursing, swearing, cussing, you know, using a foul, low vibe language, and that's kind of my definition here. But now the official definition, it is a curse is a word, a series of words, or an expression used in swearing or calling for harm to come to someone. You know, so here we have, you know, definitely an intent of harm that is expressed in language and sometimes in foul language. So sometimes, you know, these curses can be more formal than just spur of the moment. You know, when we deal with entities to harm somebody, you know, or we forcing entities, you know, to harm somebody, you know, entities that are not volunteers. You know, and there's also other tech, you know, this works, you know, for a spell. In general, these are just all thought form amplifiers, or, you know, strong thought forms that have been built. So, you know, yeah, people use crystals to hold the thought forms or talismans. You know, or create them, you know, thought forms or vibrations through psionic or Rife machines. You know, and basically you can use, you know, any tech that pulses or resonates, you know, your force field. And, you know, this is this whole concern about, you know, advanced technologies like cell phones and, you know, all the different transmitter systems, you know, and of course, you know, the military has explored these things. I mean, I would fire any general that would not know about those things and explore those things, right? I mean, those guys are not stupid. So, you know, there is this technology, and if it's not from the humans, you know, there are other beings, you know, that probably have technology. So, you know, then there is, like, curses through, and I'm not saying this is a complete list, but just to widen your horizon, you know, it's not just like, I hate you kind of a thing, or the dirty eyes, you know, then there's this whole voodoo doll tech, you know, where somebody gets a representation and attaches it and, you know, hurts it in all kinds of ways, which is in a way like a, let's say, a primitive psionic or Reich machine. And, of course, and there's also this whole thing of hypnosis and post-hypnotic suggestions. You know, we all know the Manchurian Candidate, but also this kind of stuff can happen, you know, accidentally in anesthesia. When you are under, you know, your subconscious is completely open, and so whatever is, you know, is being talked about is taken as face value, so it's better for surgeons and stuff to be quiet during operations, so to not, you know, affect the subconscious, you know. But this would not be a curse, but it works like a spell or a curse, because your subconscious, you know, takes those thought forms without filtering. And, you know, and then there's, of course, you know, this whole thing of ultra programming and conditioning, you know, like in, you know, it has been used, you know, to for dark operations, you know, to ensure operational security, you know, and those things, you know, have, of course, self-destruct and suicide programs with them, you know, which can be considered curses. Now, I mean, there is more, and, you know, this gets pretty dark, and I don't want to scare anybody, you know, whatever has happened has already happened, so it's not going to get worse, it's going to get better for you, you know, as you learn about those things. So, for instance, to give you some idea of curses, which are not just this thing, for instance, you know, I found out in my work, this, of course, we all know, or hopefully you know, that the French Revolution was triggered by a mini ice age, you know, where they had, I think, about 5 years of, you know, really, you know, cold weathers, cold winters and misharvests. And due to mismanagement, you know, by the French aristocracy, you know, people were starving and dying, you know, in huge numbers. And so I know of an individual, you know, that whose family, you know, somehow, whose village died of starvation, and he sent several thousand angry and hungry ghosts, you know, of those people that starved to death, you know, to those responsible, and to have their way with them, you know. And so this, in a way, was, you know, a curse, you know, sending entities, and these were volunteers, I would say. Mm-hmm. And so another example is, and this comes from my own work with clients, for instance, the Spanish Armada, you know, that sunk in the British Channel, you know, to this storm that wiped them all out, you know, this was also, you know, due to spell that was done, and, you know, heavy duty sacrifices too. And on a much more common level that many of us probably, you know, have experienced or know people that have experienced, you know, so thugs, people that really hurt other people, as well as, of course, murderers, you know, or even, you know, soldiers, you know, that thing, they can go around and kill people without being cursed by the loved ones, you know, of their victims, you know. I think they're greatly mistaken. You know, I mean, you surely get cursed by those, you know, as well as probably you might have a lot of angry ancestors like aunties and deceased granddads, you know, plus that person itself sometimes that got killed, that came after that person that killed them and just harassed them, you know, at night when they want to go to sleep and close their eyes, boom, they are there, or they vibe them or give them thoughts of guilt. So, you know, knowing about these things makes you actually a better person because, you know, you're not getting away with things, right? So we also become pretty much suspicious of being cursed when we discover a pattern of bad luck and accidents, you know, or if there's a family history of bad luck, you know, accidents and suicide, you know, miscarriages, you know, there's, you know, once you see a pattern, you know, it's like, you know, not everything is necessarily genetic. So also, you know, many people feel trapped or blocked, you know, for no apparent reason, and or there is a pattern of self-sabotage, you know, or an unexplainable lack of energy. You know, this pretty much, you know, guarantees that you have been cursed in past lifetime with all kinds of spells. But, you know, it could also be just ghosts, you know, many times it's ghosts and also all physical trauma that is generally carried by ghosts. And, you know, anywhere there was trauma in past lifetimes, there is generally a ghost. You know, they don't just leave there. Somehow this disturbs the process. So, but I find that the most common spells, you know, done are love spells. You know, even in this lifetime when I was running a New Age store for a year, I was just amazed, you know, how much love spell paraphernalia was being sold. So, I mean, it's such a common, you know, way, you know, to get what you want, you know, or to get even, you know, with some, you know, even if you have no power, you know, through black magic, you know, you could, well, even if you have no, let's say, physical power, like a strong body or you're rich and influential, you know, through black magic, people could get even. And, you know, this is one of the reasons, you know, that it was used so much. I once read a study on the black magic practices of the Native Americans, and I mean, I'm just quoting here. Please don't be offended in any way. So, you know, but basically the gist of the book, after interviewing a lot of people and looking at historical records, most of those that practice magic, you know, and were kind of supposed to be proven to black magic, you know, very, very poor, very, very poor, you know, very, very decrepit. And so this was the only way, you know, they could, you know, either get even or, you know, get what they needed, you know, for survival. So, well, there wasn't much, you know, about a greedy Native American using black magic, I have to say. Not in that report. No, I'm just, it just came to me. It's interesting. Because a lot of, you know, other wealth that I've seen, you know, as many people has come from black magic in past lifetimes at least, you know, and of course many times also in this lifetime. The problem with this is always, I find, you know, whatever you get through those dark things, you cannot enjoy it. You know, yeah, you get it, but you can't enjoy it. It's just like, you know, with those genie stories, you know, yeah, you get your three wishes, but, you know, they all go wrong. So that is why I always, you know, do ask that whatever happens in and from these videos and my session or my activities is for the highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. And so it is, and so it is, and so it is. So, And in this guided meditation, so we will be facing the music, you know, to clear as many spells and curses that were put on us, you know, as well as whatever spells and curses we put on others, you know, in this or past lifetime. I mean, that is just fair. And I have to say, you know, with my empiric experience of past lives and going to the trouble spot, so pretty much everybody, you know, has walked the dark side. You know, even if they have a proven track record of walking in the light in this lifetime, it's just part of spiritual education, it seems. You know, so once, you know, we know, you know, how it is to be on the dark, we, you know, we can really make a choice. You know, like the saying goes, you know, nobody is more pious than a reformed whore. Right, so there we go. And also, you know, to my new and old video viewers, you know, these videos are all designed as a loose system of self-empowerment, you know, liberation, and, you know, finally, you know, ascension. So if you respond well, you know, to these type of guided meditations, you know, and it affects you strongly, our chances, you know, are that you will get good results with my other guided meditation. And so try, you know, try those out and, you know, try to get out of the web of the matrix. And of course, you know, these are just shotgun meditations, you know, that still can affect you quite deeply, you know, but of course, you know, it is much stronger, you know, to have a private Skype session, you know, with me. Like, you know, from YouTube, for instance, you can learn how to fix parts of your car by yourself, and I've done so myself, but, you know, I wouldn't do the transmission by myself. And so maybe some of those meditations just show you, hey, you know, you got some major stuff here, and that you may need some help. And so before, you know, we start with this guided meditation, I have to point out some important principles, you know, to guarantee, you know, the success. First of all, you know, sit in a comfortable office chair, you know, where you can balance, you know, or stack your body. So make sure that everything, you know, stacks up nicely, you know, so, you know, that no muscles kind of get overstrained. You know, it's difficult to enjoy bliss when your back hurts, you know, and also, you know, if you're slumped, you will be low energy. Use, you know, earbuds or headphones, you know, to cancel out outside distraction, you know, much better sound quality. And if you listen to a podcast, you know, I mean, do not drive or operate heavy machinery while following this meditation. And of course, always smile like an idiot and reside in your heart, you know, unless you smile. You're pretty much, you know, blocking out love. You know, with your smile, you tune into the love vibration, and with your frowning, you tune into the pain vibration. And breathe also at a pace, you know, that you really can hear, you know, the air flowing through your nostrils. You know, I cannot talk enough about that. I have seen so many spiritual practices around the world, and I have to say, those that really carry a humfta, there is a lot of breathing involved, because breath is life force. Breath is life force. And this really helps you. And you know, you don't have to repeat my affirmations. Just think, amen, or so it is, and so be it. Yes, yeah. Not your head, you know, just a line. I'm not your mom or daddy and, you know, your guru. So this is your life and this is your will. Right? And be in a childlike state of innocence during the guided meditation. You know, this means residing in your heart. And then just pay attention to what pops into your mind. You know, do not judge or try to rationalize at that moment. You know, you can always do that at the end. This is like trying to rationalize your dreams about doing a dream. You know, it's just going to knock you out of the dream. Mm-hmm. And so Let's just close our eyes now. And whatever we connect now, it is going to be the organic aspect of this, because there are artificial overlays that you could consider filters created by thought forms and other tech, let's say over the sun and other beings, like even misconception. You could call it also an overlay of matrix. So we ask that these, you know, artificial overlays about the real things be, you know, sidestepped, and so we, you know, access the organic, you know, thing in itself. All right. So we connect now to the organic source, you know, source of everything, nothing, nobody higher. And our highest self and all our spirit guides all the way up to source and to Milky Way galaxy as a more local physical representation of source, and the sun and the earth and the elements of earth and the directions of earth and all the beings that are still loving us unconditionally. Thank you for coming. Amen. And I ask that everything that happens in and from the session is going to be for the highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen. I also ask that we use our time in the most effective, efficient way. Getting, you know, most done, you know, getting done whatever we can handle right now. And that it just, you know, integrates beautiful and easy. And, you know, we asked again our higher self, our inner child, our spirit guides, all incarnations that can help and support us, you know, all the star tribes coming from unconditional love, our the higher dimensions coming from unconditional love, that are supporting, you know, human ascension, you know. We ask them to, you know, to help us in this meditation, to clear as much as possible. Amen. And of course we ask that there's no deception at all. Amen. And now smile like an idiot and imagine that you send, you know, your spine as a root and also your legs as a deep root into the earth, and to allow her love to flow up into you, all the way into your heart. Mm-hmm. And, you know, with your inhale, you know, you just draw her love, even support this to flow even stronger into you. And then from the exhale, you know, with the exhale, you send your love, your energy, you know, from heart downward through your spine and your legs into the earth, and smile and deep breathing all the way in and all the way out. Smile like an idiot and back and forth. And now put your tongue onto the palate, and on the exhale you take that love that you took in from Mother Earth and send it even higher into your brain and all the way out the top of the head, you know, thus activating your more celestial energy centers, you know, parts of your energy body, you know, that connects you to the more subtle realms. And again, smile like an idiot, you know, you're starting to connect with the higher dimensions now. And now, we asked and we allow, you know, the love of the cosmos to spill down over and through our heads, shoulders, to our heart, through the arms, hands, legs, feet, deep into the earth. So just on the inhale, you just draw this in and, you know, push it down, and of course also, you know, allow it to flow, but you work with it, with your visualization. Mm-hmm. And we asked our higher spirit guides to please cleanse our body with these waves of loving chi that are flowing through and over us. Please find or remove and clear all any resistances that are there in the energy flow. Amen. And now, while we're still, you know, running this love, we ask Source and beings like Archangel Michael or anybody else who is qualified, you know, beings like Lord Shiva for the Hindu tradition, to remove, you know, as much as possible any Anunnaki, Draco, Grey, you know, or magicians or any other beings, predatory courts and devices, you know, and any other technology, you know, through which, you know, our energy is being stolen or through which, you know, we are being contaminated, you know, like karma dumping, you know, or even manipulated against, you know, the desires of our high self, you know. And please remove those now from every level of our being, from any incarnation, time or dimensions, for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes now. Amen, 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 amen. Please be with us. This is really important. Stand behind that. This is your affirmation. Mm-hmm. And observe the shift in your energy. And now you allow, you know, this love coming in from the heavens to pump your heart up just like a lotus flower, like a rose, you know, that just becomes really white and nice and fluffy. Mm-hmm. Deep breathing. You want to hear the air flowing through your nostrils and keep your mouth closed. Very important, keep your mouth closed. Otherwise you divert chi into your womb or wherever you are. I mean, unless you're in nature. When you're out in nature, you know, yeah, you can release chi, but I wouldn't do that in my room. Mm-hmm. Now imagine that there is a big laser that's about as wide as your head going through your head, you know, all the way up to Milky Way galaxy, to that bulge, that center bulge, and all the way through your spine, all the way to the core of the Earth Mother. Just, you know, breathe through that, identify with this, have it become strong, just like a one of those lightsabers from Star Wars. This is a little bit more impersonal, but it's a lot stronger, I find. Mm-hmm. And now we ask this liquid light to come in and dissolve also some blocks and blobs or clouds of darkness in us that's in your spine and in your energy body. Mm-hmm. And you might feel this coming through you in waves. I feel it always in waves. And we invite this stuff to come into our heart now, to dissolve any pain or darkness that we can detect. And just make sure, just make sure, just make sure you smile like an idiot. You know, that is your dial for love. And just breathe in. Mm-hmm. Get your heart chakra going, all right. And now, you know, listen and just, you know, confirm in yourself, you know, head nodding or just go along with it. So please, spirit, please release all the following curses that were put onto me, you know, the body, mind, and spirit complex, you know, and all that would put by me, you know, meaning my body, mind, and spirit complex, you know, unto others. So this includes structures, you know, like reverse crowns and rings and stabby things, or thought forms, or even devices, or entities, or orientations, or effects, you know, associated with these following curses. You know, they will come later, but across all incarnations, means all space, all time, all parallel realities, parallel universes, alternate realities, alternate universe, all planetary systems, all source systems, all dimensions and the void, you know, from now on. Now, amen. And so from now on we will call this clearing, you know, a clearing for, you know, all creation. You know, this means from us to others, from others to us, and through all, you know, other creation where this ever manifests. And so, you know, there are these curses, you know, of bondage. A big, you know, subject, you know, bondage, like binding spells. You know, these are like where you get stuck in the astral. You know, you cannot move on into the higher dimensions. Where you get stuck in a crystal or in a vessel, you know, for a scientific experiment to be implanted into a cyborg or into a clone or golem, or to be put into some kind of chimera and, you know, clone scientific experiment. You know, this stuff started in Atlantis. So, these types of, you know, if you like to have that cleared, amen. And then, you know, in types of bondage, you know, there are those slave spells, you know, they put chains in there and slave colors and handcuffs. And so these things generally follow from incarnation to incarnation. So all this, you know, put onto our lifetimes, you know, there are many of them trapped, I guarantee you this, as well as we enslaved others, we like to have this all cleared throughout creations. Please, 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 amen, 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 amen. And just smile and just, you know, breathe like an idiot. Pull in the love from heaven and earth into your heart and keep pumping your heart with love. Stay and smile. You know, even if you start feeling a lot of pain, you know, smiling will open you to the love vibration and, you know, make the pain go away faster. Send the love into the pain. Love is like morphine. And now there is this huge subject of love spells, right? So, and with the love spell, we take the will, the free will of the other person away and just, you know, bind them to us in certain ways, right? There's a lot of variations on that theme. And, but the problem is that, you know, their free will is being violated and those spells, they go over lifetimes and it creates a lot of havoc, especially, you know, with, you know, suddenly people start to act very irrational, you know, meeting other people. This is many times through love spells and of course, in so many love times, we desired, you know, another person so badly, you know, so much that, you know, yeah, the only way, you know, we thought we could you know, get out of this, you know, we created those love spells. So, of course, these also, you know, go not just only for love, but also, you know, for sexuality. So we like to have all this cleared from us to others and others to us, you know, throughout creation. Please now, amen, 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 and that. Of course, we always ask that all those karmas be cleared and all those beings, you know, be brought back into the heavens. Mm-hmm. And, you know, then of course, you know, there are also so-called bitch spells. And with bitch, I mean in the term of prison bitch, that you kind of, you know, throughout the incarnations, you are subservient, you know, to this person. So this was done a lot with kings, pharaohs, you know, just people, you know, that had an entourage or, you know, black magicians that wanted to make sure, you know, that these beautiful women or partners would always be available to them throughout the lifetimes. And, you know, for whatever purposes they needed. So, yes, we like to have those cleared, please, throughout our creations. Amen, 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 amen. So, and then, you know, so of course, with love, you know, so many powerful vows and curses were done because there's so much emotion behind it. So I would consider to vow to love nobody else or to be cursed to love nobody else than one person. You know, this is pretty much the same. And so we like to have, you know, these type of vows or curses cleared throughout creation. And if it's just even, you know, maybe, you know, only loving a deity, you know, I don't think that, you know, this exclusiveness of love is in the plan of the Creator. I think all of creation should be loved. And so we like to have this cleared, you know, for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen, 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 amen. And, you know, let's just go to some more, while this dissolves, some other love spells that I find a lot are there. You know, to, again, love nobody else and to never find love. And, you know, to always find the wrong person, you know, or to always be rejected or to have no fertility, right? You know, there are a lot of variations. So we asked, you know, our highest and smartest spirit guides, you know, to track all those vows, spells, curses down and just clear them throughout creations for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen. And that any karma damage, you know, be cleared and entities released. Amen. And, you know, another, you know, really bread and butter, you know, are just, you know, spells that were done, you know, out of hate. So whenever in a past life regression, you know, whether you are a therapist or you do it by yourself, you know, you kind of come about situation of torture, rape, slavery, incarceration and betrayal, you can be pretty much, you know, be very sure that these people got very, very angry, traumatized and disturbed, and not only, you know, got stuck as ghosts, you know, because they had a hard time letting go, but they also did a lot of cursing, you know, maybe not too formal. Maybe if they had time, if they were knowledgeable, maybe they were formal, or if they had money, they would hire somebody, an expert at that, you know. But a lot of that stuff was just inspirational, you know. When you see your loved one tortured in front of you, or you get tortured for a longer time, yeah, I mean, you know, you curse, you know, the bodily liquids out of somebody. You know, it's the emotions are so strong and all this pain gets transferred into hate and darkness and gets projected, you know, in thought forms onto whoever, you know, you hate at that time. And sometimes I have seen it, you know, people turned to the dark side through those kind of experiences, you know, especially I've seen it like, you know, the, anyhow, princesses were buried alive, for instance, you know, or there wasn't a princess like queens and entourage was buried alive. And that did not suit very well. They got very angry then. So anyhow, where this happened, you know, to us, or where we made this happen to others, we apologize. We give forgiveness, we ask for forgiveness, and we ask this all this please be cleared throughout creations now. Amen, 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 amen. And I just smile and keep breathing. Yeah, this is going to be, you know, a big one for you. Just keep breathing. If you have to cry, let it rip. Don't try to suppress crying. Just express it, but you know, try to smile as much as you can and keep breathing deeply. The more you smile, you know, the faster it will integrate and move over you, you know, and out of you. And it's always good, you know, to pronounce, I'm so sorry, please forgive me. You know, I forgive you, I love you, I'm so sorry, please forgive me, I love you, I forgive you. It will always help, you know, and breathe earth love into the heavens now. That will also help this process of clearing, you know, bringing stuff from the lower vibration into the higher vibrational space. Alright, there may be more, you know, on this theme, and, you know, just go over this another time. Now this next one is going to be very big, and it's not so much known, but I run across it pretty much, you know, every time I work with somebody, and these are divide and conquer spells. And these have not only been applied by humans, but also a lot by reptilians, Alpha Draconians, you know, the Anunnaki, the gods. You know, the gods did it among themselves, or the higher dimensionals, or the creator beings, you know, depending on how you look at them. You know, it's really just the words, you know, but so they did this among themselves, you know, and especially also, you know, in all kinds of rebellions against the creator. You know, there were always lots of different opinions and rebellions, and so, and so many times divide and conquer spells were applied, you know, also in so many terms of jealousy. It's a real easy one. Some, you know, use the sword of divide and conquer. So, you know, and so we like to have all this cleared, you know, wherever we were involved in divide and conquer spells, you know, whether it's receiving or giving, and please, 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 we clear those all. We ask the cosmic Christ, you know, God's sources, aspect of divine love and forgiveness to just, you know, put the mercy out on this, you know, and just clear, clear, clear all the stuff. Now, amen, 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 amen. And smile like an idiot and breathe. Yeah, keep deep breathing. You want to hear your air flowing through your nostrils. Mm-hmm. Smile like an idiot. All the way in, all the way out, especially if you are athletic. Breathe as much as you can. Mm-hmm. And we ask another round of clearing for this now. Amen. Same stuff, just the final calming. And if there are any resistances towards clearing this, please final remove and clear those resistances too, as long as it is for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen. and you may feel an upflow of energy above your head, and that is always a surefire sign that you're clearing. Also, when you feel tingling, it's always a good sign. Just keep smiling like an idiot. That will keep you connected with the love vibration. And maybe while this is going on, so in so many lifetimes when we were walking on the dark path, you know, or maybe we were just on the receiving end, you know, there has been a lot of cursing or negative programming, you know, of the elements, like the air, you know, to maybe get winds to destroy fleets. You know, Japan also. The tribes there, Mongolians, you know, they had a huge fleet that also got sunk. You know, these were probably shamans against shamans fighting, you know, putting spells and curses onto the elements. So wherever, you know, we were involved this, like, again, on elements like the air, like the wind, like the weather, like the water, you know, poison the water, you make it poisonous, you know, send it bad energy, battle energies, etc. Also the earth, you know, so many times, probably when there was neighborly dispute, you know, the earth, the land and the wells were cursed to bring bad energy. You know, or we sent earthquakes, and well, in Atlantis, in those fights, I've seen it many times, when the humanoids were fighting with the reptilians, they used earthquake weapons, and you know, it was through vibrations, through chi, and magic, you could say magic. There was a lot of, you know, powerful visualization there. And you can consider that curses, and whenever we were involved in this, you know, we again apologize to the Earth Mother or to whatever planet we did this, and we like to have all this cleared and released. You know, also curses and spells that were put onto metals, like gold, I think there's a lot of stuff on there. You know, amulets, etc. You know, those things. All this we like to have cleared, you know, in either direction and always. Now, amen, 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 throughout all creation. Amen, 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 amen. And then when that is done, replace it with positive programming, the most positive program that Creator will allow. Amen, 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 amen. Surprises, Creator. And smile, and just, you know, keep pumping your heart with love. And, you know, this can probably go on for a long time. So another really big thing in cursing is like, and this is very heavy duty. You know, this is not your normal witchy stuff, your little stuff, you know. It's like where we dump, you know, bad karma onto others, you know, and not just dump our bad karma onto others, but to, you know, program it to follow them around lifetime after lifetime. So other people become like the Dorian Gray of our life, you know, this painting of the Dorian Gray where all the bad karma just shows on the painting and not on the person that looks like innocent and pure. So where, you know, dark magicians do the bad things, and then all that bad karma that they're accumulating just is being sent to one of those, yeah, you know, that's what I would call bitches, but, you know, this is just the technology of karma dumping. So where we do that with others, or where we're on the receiving end, please, 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 the highest divine forces, clear all that karma either way, and make sure this stops, put the divine seals on this, and just clear this out throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. Yeah, and we asked all the high selves that are involved in this to also forgive each other and, you know, grant each other forgiveness. Amen, 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 amen. Oh, yeah. And with all of the spell and curses, I, you know, summoned and asked all the high selves, you know, to cooperate on this. You know, under the supervision of Source, you know. So you're being observed how you're performing. Amen, 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 amen. So, and while this is going on, you know, there also has been a lot of black magic done. And this was part, you know, of spiritual warfare, basically. You know, I've seen it in all kinds of cultures. You know, in Atlantis, you know, when, you know, the scientists and magicians, you know, were bickering and amongst each other, jealous, you know, having different projects. And, you know, behold, this culture, you know, was like 40, 60, you know, 1,000 years, you know, a long time. A lot of stuff happened in this time, you know, and so, you know, a lot of stuff, you know, happened there, a lot of the higher magic. So, you know, but also just under shamans and, you know, in the medieval time, you know, for battle, you know, this was, I mean, Attila the Hun, you know, was supposed to be a great shaman. You know, they all kind of saw things or had shamans working for them, you know, what the enemy was doing and how to do the battle. You know, all this, you know, even Christianity, you know, is involved with this being that calls itself, you know, Yahweh. You know, that's not Source, that's Anunnaki, I guess, you know. So, but, you know, this is, everybody can figure this out for themselves. You know, and connect to Source. So one of the first steps is always, you know, to kind of dampen the third eye and to disconnect that person from, you know, their high selves and then also their spirit guides. You know, blind them, like in a street fight, you know, just sand in the eyes, they can't see. Much easier to take them out, you know. So, however, you know, we kind of diverted the connection or block the connection to other people's high selves, you know, or to our own high self. Whatever we did, you know, we like to have cleared through our creation or whatever was done to us. Amen, 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 amen. And just now you start breathing, you know, learning love with the heavens. And any negative energy that's being, you know, sent to us now is coming to surface. Any implants we like to have cleared now. Amen, 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 amen. Amen. Also any beings that are trying to attack us now, we like to have tagged, hunted down and brought to the highest courts of spiritual justice for any transgression against spiritual will and contracts. Amen, 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 amen. This is not allowed. Also, any contracts with them, you know, that where they claim or they're allowed to attack us. Yeah, we like to have those taken to the highest courts of spiritual justice and see, you know, if they ever intended to clear them or to fulfill them, whether they actually did. Whether they fulfilled the contract and whether they're actually collecting on stuff that was not delivered, right? So we like to have those contracts cleared and the effects cleared and those entities banished unless, you know, they are willing to, you know, open themselves up to divine love and accept the heart chakra. So let's have them brought to the Arcturian Healing and Ascension Chamber. And whether they can make their choice where they want to go. Amen. But they're not allowed here anymore. We're around us. Amen, 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 amen. In the name of Source, in the name of Source, in the name of Absolute Source. And so it is. And so it is. And so it is. All right. And then another type of curses is like where you misalign with your Dharma. And Dharma means life, purpose, divine life's purpose. You know, a lot of the dark, you know, all the way up into the higher dimensionals, you know, these curses, you know, on divine beings here. You know, besides the divide and conquer, you know, misalignment, you know, to the Dharma was also bread and butter, so we like to have that cleared in every direction throughout creations. Now, amen. And that can take some long time. And so, while this is going on, we ask that any attacks that come through familiars be cleared. And let me just explain this before we, you know, give in the order. In many lifetimes, magicians, witches, you know, all kinds of shamans, you know, worked with familiars. These are many times, you know, animals, like a raven, or like an eagle, or like a cat, or a wolf, you know, they would mind melt with them and see through their eyes. Send out the raven to see, you know, what enemy forces are doing, what your enemies are doing, or, you know, to check out things. You know, they have sometimes, you know, special gifts like access to realms, a different point of view, etc. And so, you know, this was just like having a pet, but, you know, having a spiritual relationship, you know, with your pet, where your pet is actually, you know, a yogi. Wouldn't you now relate, you know, as yogis with each other? I mean, that's just one of the archetypes. And so, you know, this was a really tricky one, used by really tricky magicians. So you would, like, you know, program the pet or the familiar, you know, to attack or to give, you know, wrong information, you know, to their master. And that way you could do a hit on somebody without, you know, getting, you know, fingered and blamed yourself. So wherever we did this, or it was done to us, you know, or where our, you know, where, you know, any familiars were hurt, you know, we like to have all this cleared. I'm so sorry. Please clear this through our creation. Amen, 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 amen. And of course, you know, when we talk about familiars, you know, it's getting a little bit more out there. So, you know, there's this whole realm of possession, where, you know, we used other people as zombies, basically mind controlled them. You know, a Manchurian candidate would be like a more primitive way, but, you know, where we basically mind merged with somebody and let them do their dirty work for us. And we didn't even know what they were doing. And then, you know, then they take, you know, the blame, or we used others, you know, for shields for our actions. So this is like a technique, you know, done by, you know, headhunters, you know, where the heads of the killed people, you know, they trap the ghost of those people, and then all the anger from other people is redirected to those ghosts, you know, and they become kind of trash cans for the karma and the anger of their surroundings. So this would be an example of using somebody as a shield. So this probably has happened to all of us as part of psychic warfare when you were in a higher vibrational consciousness in the good old times. And so we like to have all the stuff cleared, you know, whether we were victims or victimizers. Please do so now. Amen. And smile and breathe deeply, breathe into your heart. You know, do the I love you, I'm so sorry, please forgive me, I forgive you. And also run a lot of love into the heavens, right. And you ask for heavenly vacuum cleaners to keep pulling that stuff out of you. Mm-hmm. Amen, 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 amen. And then, of course, you know, through magic, you know, there has been a lot of end contracts, you know, but then these were mostly cheating contracts. There has been a lot of stealing, you know, of talents, good karma and resources. You know, it's not just only life force that is being stolen from different chakras, you know, but also like wealth, you know, good karma, wealth, beauty, power, spirituality, you know. Some curses, you know, were also to just to govern spirituality, to make sure it doesn't go above a certain point, you know. Very important has been done by the Anunnaki a lot, also by the reptilian, to keep us subservient. Mm-hmm. Also, you know, stealing, you know, good luck and even peace and harmony and manifestation skills, you know, and whatever good you can imagine, you know, those probably have been intended to be stolen. And so, you know, if you like to have all this and maybe stuff that we haven't mentioned yet, but that should be cleared now by our highest spirit guides, all the way up to source. Amen, 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 throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. And this is probably going to take a long time. But in the meantime, let's just go and further on. And there has always been, you know, this kind of curses of misfortune. You know, very general. Very general, you know. You know, it's just, you know, misfortune in every way. And so, yeah, you know, we like to have, you know, those all cleared, you know, in every direction, in every way. You know, this even probably happens just doing traffic. But there is lots of it, you know, not too sophisticated, but lots of it. So if you like to have all this cleared throughout creation, and we probably need the most powerful angels to do so, please do so now. Amen. If you're a Hindu, you know, we ask Lord Shiva, you know, the aspect of, you know, absolute creator, that is Lord Shiva, you know, not so much the historical person, I would say. You know, to, you know, as the, so the God aspect of Shiva, you know, the principle of creation aspect of Shiva that transmutes poisons, you know, to please clear all that stuff. Amen, 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 amen. Oh, yeah. And just smile and keep breathing. This would be quite strong for many of you. Mm-hmm. And while this is going on, you know, in so many lifetimes, and this was also done a lot by the reptilians and Anunnaki and higher dimensionals, you know, to keep humans, you know, at bay. This were like spells and curses and thought forms and manipulation towards confusion, you know, self-doubt spell programs, you know, and one of the real, very simple, in a way, you know, let's say, you know, your higher self gets through to you and you get this great idea, you know, everything, you know, they just have to do, all right, let's give them the opposite idea. And so then you get the opposite idea too, and then you're just on the mental plane, you know, pushing around concepts, you know, losing, you know, your valuable download in doubt and confusion, you know, which keeps you stuck. So, you know, it has been used a lot, so we like to have this all cleared from creation, you know, where we were involved in any way. Amen, 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 amen. And while this is going on, then there's of course this huge thing that we all find, you know, which is self-sabotage. In so many cases, it's facilitated by ghosts that hate us, that want to, you know, disturb us. But also there are spells and curses out like that. And sometimes this is also ghosts that, you know, don't want us, you know, to be successful because, you know, we were hurt when we were successful. You know, and it's not always so great to be famous or beautiful. You know, it's a lot of envy and jealousy and backstabbing happening then. So many people, you know, decided not to be powerful and successful anymore, and they start self-sabotaging then. So all this stuff, you know, especially those vows also that self-sabotage you, maybe through guilt, you know, also, you know, if you like to have clear now. Amen, 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 amen on all creation. And whatever, you know, else witchcraft is there, you know, that we haven't mentioned, you know, this and that, you know. Whatever is no serving the highest good anymore. You know, you like to have cleared as much as possible by the divine forces. Amen, 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 amen. And now, while this is going on, let's go. Well, there's this whole thing of ritual abuse, you know, there's ritual sexual abuse, you know, through torture, killing, you know, all kinds of things probably happened to most of us in the past. You know, Babylon was great and it really big, but it was done pretty much in all the cultures, you know, look at the sacrifices, you know, in Middle America, you know, Mexico, the Maya, you know, blood sacrifices were done pretty much in all cultures. You know, the Celts did a lot. You know, all cultures did even human sacrifices, you know, and so, you know, there's a lot coming with this, and there's a lot of darkness around this. So it's very complicated. So we just asked, you know, for the cosmic Christ to just, you know, put so much mercy out there. And we asked, you know, the liberators of this creation, you know, like aspects like Archangel Michaels, but other beings like the Vishnu Dutas for the Hindus, you know, to come and, you know, to just, you know, dissolve all this and liberate everybody so that nobody gets stuck and is being tortured anymore. Amen, 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 amen. So please clear this from all creation as much as possible. Amen. Yeah, and just keep breathing. Breathe earth love into the heavens and smile like an idiot. And, well, on a lighter note, here in America, you know, there is something that's called government cheese, which is like an artificial cheese that is freely available. And in a similar way, you know, in some governments, like in Egypt, there were what I personally call government spells out there. So when you were a murderer, for instance, in a certain time period, you know, you not only got incarcerated, you know, maybe till you died, you know, maybe you got also tortured in certain way, and then there was certain magic done to your bones, and that magic, you know, was done to cut your power, you know, to just cut your power. You wouldn't have much power, access to power in future lifetimes, and other bad stuff, and probably there was also a lot of energy vampiring going on, you know, as a punishment. And so, you know, everybody kind of in Egypt seemed to know what's going to happen when you step out of line. So I call this government spells, and probably government spells were used in all kinds of cultures, you know, as part of the penal system, whether it's China, Babylon, etc., right? So, you know, so we probably have been on the giving and receiving end of government spells, and you know, it's time to clear all this stuff now. For the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes, we ask the divine forces to just clear all this trauma, karma, etc. Amen, 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 amen. Yeah, then another level of that, and probably several levels of this till all it's gone. And if there's still any resistances or booby traps or hooks, you know, for any hooks we ask, hooks in any magic, we ask that the barbs be cleared, that of course all the booby traps around all the vows and curses, you know, that have been done be cleared, all the booby traps, right? as well as any poisons associated with this. Amen, yeah. And of course, if necessary, those that are still dishing the stuff out, you know, be tagged and brought to the highest courts of spiritual justice, you know, to stop this, maybe contain them. Amen. So, now let's a little bit more down to earth. You know, there were flesh wounds, of course, you know, from fights. And, you know, if there were like more advanced martial artists, you know, you project dark chi, you know, and dark chi is real nasty stuff that's stored in the bones, you know. I wouldn't want to carry that around. But, you know, this has been done. So it's anything from dark chi to anger and hate, you know, and maybe the ki ai. That's one form of putting energy into this. You know, and sometimes it was done also with like a spell or curse at that moment of impact. And sometimes it was done with a magical weapon that was, you know, designed to also damage the subtle bodies. And actually a lot of that really was done perfectly. The Anunnaki and the Rakshasas, the Alpha Draconians, they were masters of that. Actually, they used the battlefield of Kurukshetra to affect a lot of people, you know, with their magic weapons that caught you throughout the lifetimes and you become somebody's bitch in certain ways. You know, they can control you like a puppet on the string and siphon your energy, you know. So that's a really big one, and we like to have this cleared by source. Really big one. So, you know, throughout creation, you know, for you and everybody involved, giving and receiving, and amen. Yeah, smile and breathe. That's huge. This is huge. This is huge. Smile and breathe. And of course, you know, then there's this whole realm of entities and ghost attachments, you know, that are sent. I already talked about this at the beginning of this video. So it's not just only ghosts that are being, you know, sent to somebody. You know, all kinds of beings can be sent to somebody to create havoc. You know, archons are just one of them. And there's also like an entity pairing, you know, maybe voluntarily or involuntarily, you know, we were paired or we paired others in past lifetimes with other entities, you know, to make them more vicious, to make them stronger, you know, to have more mystic powers, more insight in the astral realm, you know, different purposes. And you can consider this as curses, because there are a lot of disadvantages with this, and you know, we ask that this be cleared now as much as possible on all levels and all creations by the highest divine beings now. Amen. And if there are any resistances towards clearing this stuff, you know, please do so now. Amen. And of course, you know, a lot of, you know, cursing and programming, you know, is done with booby traps, you know, for the healers as well as, you know, for the person, you know, that has been programmed. And you know, there are many times, you know, suicide programs or just blocks or governors, you know, or sub-personalities, you know, that are self-destructive that are popping up. You know, this is old technology as well as more new military technology, you know, wherever they know their secrets or people are considered expendable. You know, this is being done, you know, just like an assassin that kills himself after he'd done his job, you know. And so, you know, this whole, you know, thing with booby traps, you know, it's quite complicated. And so we asked the organic cosmic Christ to please transmute all these curses and spells, you know, that are, you know, still left here, you know. that haven't been addressed yet, you know, whether this is from a personal level, you know, or on a bloodline level, you know, or on tribes, you know, or races or groups, you know. So many spells and curses have been put onto groups, you know. Right now the Jews were cursed a lot, and they're still affecting them and all kinds of, you know, I mean, you know, all the neighbors probably cursed each other sooner or later, you know, in so many countries, you know, like Ireland, oh God, you know, what went back and forth, it's just horrible, horrible, you know, so, you know, humanity is just riddled, you know, with curses on each other's, you know, whether, you know, racism, whether it's black and white or yellow, brown and red, you know, against the white man, you know, and the problem is, you know, they're just general, they're not specific, you know, they are not deserved necessarily, you know, and they're not helping the issue, they're not helping the issue. So that's why we asked, you know, Supreme Creator and all his expansions to clear this now for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen, 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 amen. Ah, yes, smile and breathe and run earth love into the heavens. Mm-hmm. Let's keep breathing, keep smiling. You know, back Creator, just clear as much as possible and help you to integrate this. Amen. And, oh, well, this has been a very, very long meditation now. And so we thank all those beings, first of all, that came and that helped us. You know, this is, you know, has been a lot of work on so many levels, you know, throughout creation. You know, this has quite an effect and ripple effects. So we really thank them. And if there are still any entities or energies that need to be moved, you know, please do so now. Amen. And if there are still any portals that should be opened or closed or guarded, please do so now. Amen. Now we become aware of the room and we slip back into our physical bodies and all our subtle bodies are getting aligned now perfectly. And wherever we have released darkness is being charged up by healing light, by golden light. Our DNA and our subtle bodies are being updated and programmed for the latest, highest updates, that is in the interest of our High Self and with the permission of our High Self only. Amen. And now you open your eyes, fully awake, back in waking day consciousness. Hello, back my friends. I hope you feel lighter and well, first of all, you know, drink a lot of water, at least a liter. If you get headaches, you have to drink more water. And this is just a shotgun meditation, and sorry it takes so long. You know, it could have taken longer. You probably just scratched the surface, you know, so many times it would have been good to just pause. But, you know, you're probably going to have a lot of clearing, and you're just going over this again and again, you know, till, you know, nothing happens anymore, you know, it's the way to go, you know, pace yourself. So much of the time, you know, you will find even that these, you know, guided meditations all have to be taken like pills or teas, you know, but have a more lasting effect. Also understand there are generally many, many layers to issues, you know, from different lifetimes. You know, also clearing is dependent on, you know, your insight, you know, and lessons that you have learned, you know, and your level of forgiveness, and of course, you know, the gravity of the curse, you know. Many issues, you know, have to be looked up in greater detail, you know, before they can be released, you know. This is, you know, whenever there is a lesson or insight needed before the trauma can be transmuted. You know, it's not anymore an eye for an eye. You know, it's more about the insight, you know, and the insight is the homework that you gotta do, you know. And so the cleansing, you know, may take time, but most likely you're probably going at breakneck speed right now, you know, and enjoy the ride. You know, it's just like with a roller coaster ride, you know, you can be scared or you can go wee, you know, so do the wee thing, you know. And so also, you know, the information density, you know, is super high here. You know, probably a lot of that stuff that you're hearing about here, you know, you never heard about. Well, there is more. So, I mean, I have been, you know, talking to high selves, you know, figuring out what has been going on, you know, for, it's nearly 35 years, maybe 40 years now. And so, you know, you get around. So there's a lot of info packed into this, you know, again, you know, listening to it several times, you know, till you get no more reaction is probably a good thing. And also just ask, you know, the highest and most accessible spirit guides, you know, to help you, you know, through books, YouTube info, websites, people, nature, dreams, or medicines, you know, whatever it is that will help you, what is for your highest good. Really, if you want to go on the fast track, you know, treat yourself to a private Skype session with me, you know, we cut right to the chase. You know, my prices are very, very reasonable. And just, you know, send me an email, you know, or go to my website. The info is just below in the see, show more, and in the credits. So also, you know, do the cyber life stuff to keep me, you know, published on YouTube. Ring the bell, give thumbs up, you know, leave comments and questions and other messages for, you know, people that look at the videos. You know, this is your kind of community. Yeah, you know, tell also your friends, you know, live a good life, smile like an idiot. I love you. Namaste.